Hello and welcome to another episode of Cadence Fishing TV. I'm Steve Whitfield. We're at the wonderful Worsbrough Reservoir and on the outskirts of Barnsley, where I'm doing some method feeder fishing using the Cadence CS10 12-foot number 3 and the 11-foot number 3. And we'll talk about these more when I get this beauty in. That's what we've come for. Well, here we are, we're back at Worsbrough Reservoir. Absolutely love the place. Jesus. Doing some work on the dam wall, and the conditions are different to the last time we came, when the water was right up to the boards. This place just gets better. In recent matches, there were three weights over 150 pounds, I think. I think Graham Wall won the match with 184. Where Nick Speed had 177 pounds and travel companion Wayne Bartholomew had 156 pounds. Now, the match at the weekend was another ton up. Martin Dobson, 109 pounds. And when the water levels are low like this, there's nowhere for these carp to hide. If you look beyond, over to the trees, you can see that there's quite a lot of the reservoir which is dry at the minute. And it's always been the case that the carp tend to live in that shallow water. And with fish averaging 8 to 10 pounds, you can see why these weights are achievable. And there's another pristine Worsbrough carp. And a fish like that, it doesn't take long to build up that kind of weight. We'll put this one straight back. Lovely. Well, the tactics here at Worsbrough are quite simple. It's become a mecca for the method feeder. I'm using a hybrid today, and we'll talk in more detail about the feeders I'm using. So today, we're getting towards the end of May and the weather's warming up and the water's low. In winter, the fish tend to live out in the middle of the reservoir and it becomes a long-range feeder match. The difference is now we've lost quite a lot of water for the dam repairs and there's nowhere for the fish to hide. Nothing spectacular today. I'm fishing 60, 70 metres on my 12-foot rod and I'll be fishing 40 and 50 metres with my 11-foot rod. The 12-foot number 3 has become one of my favourite rods to use. Not only has it got that great playing action, it's got lots and lots of power. And that lends itself to chucking method feeders, winder feeders, a real distance. And I also like fishing with 12-foot rods. So this is the CS10 11-foot number 3. And there's an interesting backstory around how this rod was actually spawned. This rod was actually spawned on the back of the 12-foot number 3. So when we first started using the 12-foot number 3, which has got a little bit more backbone, like we said, than the number 2, it's got bigger runners, the first runners spaced out so we can use bigger reels, and this rod was just fantastic. And then I think it was Wayne who just said, oh, that would be nice in an 11-foot. So James Bin James said, we'll do it. And this is the rod what we've developed. We did start with a 3-piece and a 2-piece. And Wayne took these rods out and put them through the paces. So we decided on a 2-piece version. Yeah, as you can see, the first runners really well spaced from the boat. That ensures you can use, because we're going to use him, this is a powerful rod, we want a powerful reel. We've got the CS10 5000 on this. The ring layout is absolutely perfect. The rod comes with an ounce and a half, and a 2-ounce tip. We didn't feel the need to have a 3-ounce tip for this particular rod. In terms of application, this rod's perfect for fishing for bigger fish. Yeah, there's always a rod for a job. And this particular rod is perfect for catching those bigger fish and actually landing them fish quicker. This rod's absolutely perfect for venues where you catch those big carp, Barston, Larford, Allcroft. This rod's going to get you these big fish out. So let's talk about method feeders in general. There's two main types of method feeders. You've got the classic method, and I'm not particularly an advocate of any particular brand because I think they all have their own uses. The method feeder is where we put the ground bait on the feeder and it kind of melts down as we're fishing and the bait's exposed and the fish homing on the pellets and hopefully they're going to suck in that hook bait. The second type of feeder is like the hybrid type feeder. A banjo, yeah? The good thing about all these feeders, they're all very similar, but they do have the differences. There's some anglers don't like the holes in them because it helps break down the pellets quicker. But you can put that to good use because if you're wanting a quick bite and you want that, that's the kind of feeder to use. You can also use a feeder with no holes in the back. You're going to get a slower breakdown on that feeder. So like I say, I'm not a particular advocate of any kind of any brand of feeder, and I've got a selection. There's 4 or 5 different brands in there, and they've all got the uses. In any fishing situation, fish care is absolutely paramount. With the evolution of feeders across the board, but especially method feeders, gone are the days where we're fishing fixed feeders, where the fish can, if you lose a feeder, you get cracked off, the fish can be tethered to the feeder. All the feeders I use are fish friendly. We have the X-Safe with the stem, and we also have inline feeders. Any of these feeders, if you have an accident, if you crack off, or your main line snaps, all these feeders will come off the line and only leave the hook in the fish and they're not swimming around with a feeder. So let's have a little look at the setup. We'll start with the hook. We've got a size 10 K QM1 with a bayonet. The bayonet spikes into the wafter. I've got a 4-inch hook length, that's 9 pounds. I've got the feeder. As I said earlier, safety in mind. The actual setup's quite simple as well. There's a small inch loop at the bottom, what we attach either for a running feeder, you can attach that to your bead. We've got a twizzle loop, a twizzle line for about six inch, and they've got that knotted again there. So like with most of my feeder fishing, I've got an 8-pound shock leader and I've got 5-pound main line on the reel. You can see there's several turns on the reel. This gives me a couple of rod lengths for when I'm playing the fish and putting more pressure on and getting that fish in the net. The 5-pound main line helps with casting, much less resistance in the water, and the 8-pound shock leader helps with playing the fish at close quarters. So let's have a look how we load the feeder. It's quite simple. I'm taking a wafter, put that onto the bayonet. It's quite easy. Push it in, be careful not to push it too far because you actually want that. You want that to actually move. It's quite important that. I do like the washed out wafters. Loading the feeder couldn't be more simple. It's just a case of filling with pellets, pressing them in quite firm. You're going to put your wafter in the middle of the feeder, and then you're going to cap that off. The great thing about the banjo type, hybrid type feeders is you generally don't have to use a mould. One thing I will say, if you are casting distance, and I think we've covered this before, you do have to try and achieve something nice and symmetrical. That aids casting, that's ready to go, dead simple. That goes in the water, it'll start to break down. A minute or so in, the hook bait will be exposed. Carp comes along, simply sucks it up, and we're into a fish. So as you can see in the background there, that's Chris Trimmell. He's one of the bailiffs here at Worsbrough. And because the water's low for fish care, they're going out putting some nets out for the fish to spawn on. Just showing the care they've got for the fish here at Worsbrough. And I've got another lovely fish on the 11 foot, number 3. And I'm loving it. One thing what's important to mention, I think I've mentioned it earlier, is once you get onto this shock leader, you can start to put much more pressure on the fish and take control of the whole situation. And these carp in Worsbrough don't half fight. Another cracking Worsbrough carp. An absolutely gorgeous Worsbrough mirror. Look at the plates on that. There's a right and a wrong way of casting a method feeder, and I'm going to show you the right way. I'm going to go through this cast, and I'm going to explain the process of throwing it in, casting it in, either stopping the feeder, hitting the clip, but what you don't want to do is let this just smash into the water, because you'll skim your pellets off, you'll not be fishing effectively, and the chances of catching a fish is massively reduced. I like to cast in one motion, so I'll bring the feeder rod back, I'll put it over my right shoulder, and I'll make the cast. Before that feeder hits the water, I put my feeder on my line on the spool, just stop that feeder. That lands in the water nice, and there's one thing you can't do, Mr. TP says, and if he says it, it's right, you do not move the feeder. Thank you. another feisty, hard fighting Worsbrough carp caught on the 11 foot number 3. I'm going to make that the final fish of the day, and thanks for watching.